looking for you, Nabot.
Your Eminence, please escape. I'll cover your retreat.
Why don't you leave, Jill? Or rather, take your leave. Humans have no business here.
What? Your Eminence!
What? Magic?
Monster! People are not yours to use!
What else does one do with tools?
Please, no!
Cocoon is a factory built by Falci. A factory for the mass production of human forms.
Not anymore, it's not.
What can mere men do? Without our help, death is all of which you're capable. You saw the fools, a mindless mob drunk on fear of a viewless sea.
If they only knew a Lassie was the one filling their glasses!
Lassie? You mean me? Oh, child, perish the thought. I am more than that! I am Falci. My name is Martin Lewis. Voice of the Sanctum and Lord Sovereign of the Cocoon Falci. Your kind feared the darkness, so we gave you light. You begged us for the purge, and did it not come to pass? Now you spurn our counsel. You must learn your place.
Cocoon's nothing to you?
Can mere
Let's go! Falci running the Sanctum.
Then, I guess it wasn't Eden controlling things after all.
As I said, I am Lord Sovereign.
Guess Falci don't go down as easy as the rest of us.
Ease is not the issue. You have not fought to win. You should know quite well already the sure way of dispatching our kind. Ragnarok.
What's Ragnarok?
Pitiful Lassie. You've forgotten your focus. Ragnarok is the beast one of you must become in order to lay waste to Cocoon. You have had the dream. One among you will become that monstrosity. Defeat Orphan and destroy Cocoon.
Orphan?
The font of Eden's power. Orphan fuels Eden with strength, and Eden in turn sustains you and the rest of our kind. Destroy Orphan, and you'll release a force such as this world has never seen. Cocoon will be torn asunder.
So if I did that, destroyed Orphan?
Your focus will be fulfilled.
So what? Who says it has to be?
Sarah asked us to save Cocoon before she turned to crystal. Save it! And that's what we're gonna do. Sarah was trying to tell us how to complete our focus, and we have...
Allow me to help you see the truth of things. The moment you arrived, your friend wept crystal tears. This was because her focus required that you be brought together. That girl did nothing but assemble the tools for Cocoon's destruction. Did it never occur to you? Or did you simply refuse to countenance the thought? If you will not face the truth, then face the peril of your plight. Run, Lassie. See how stark reality is.
Coming!
Not so fast, Lassie.
Hang on! What kind of ship is this? Fighting on its own?
Clever, aren't you?
Can we do something?
Got me! I give up!
Shield.
Where are we?
Looks like a piece of pulse.
Pulse? What, you mean like the Bowden vestige? Something like that. It's close to Eden.
Yeah, well, what I don't understand is after the Purge and all that Lassie paranoia, why keep a chunk of pulse under the floorboards?
Is this what the Primarch wanted us to see?
A place for Lassie to accept their fate.
Do you really think our focus is what Dysley said it is?
You mean become Ragnarok?
Destroy the foul sea Eden and shatter Cocoon. That's what the vision's telling us, more or less. So, back to square one. Out of luck.
Mr. Hero! Cocoon calling Snow!
It's almost like Dysley wants it to come true.
Seems that way. He sure didn't mind explaining it. Here's your focus on the silver platter.
But that doesn't make sense. I don't get it. Why would a Cocoon Falsee want to destroy Cocoon?
Maybe it's a Falsee thing. You know what I mean? Some grand design we just don't understand.
Huh. Hey, Snow. Nothing from you?
So, this way?
Too much of a shock. Your brand will change, and it'll be to keep that in mind.
Don't believe everything a Falsee says. He's telling us our focus is to destroy Cocoon. But who knows? Could be lying to trick us into helping him to do something else. We should listen to Sarah, not some foul sea.
So Dysley was really the foul sea Bartandalus. The vision he was talking about was that crazy Ragnarok dream we all had when we were made into Lassie. One of us is supposed to become this Ragnarok thing and destroy Eden, except we do that by destroying this orphan that gives Eden its power. I think I have that part straight now. Are we ready to get out of here?
I gotta apologize. Looks like I was wrong.
About Sarah's focus? Not like you to second-guess yourself.
Well, even heroes make mistakes.
What about your plan to protect Cocoon? Either way, your faith in Sarah was strong. That strength got you this far.
It was all wrong.
Yeah. You tried so hard to convince us that you even fooled yourself. You've been a total idiot. But still, it saved me. You trusted Sarah. Let that faith drive you. It even made me want to believe.
I want to say we're close to Eden, but it's hard to be sure.
I can't believe we're still in Cocoon.
It's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
They called them.
Long ago, the Falsi, who made their home on Grand Pulse, were afraid of invasion from the outside. As part of their battle preparations, they created an army of living weapons, and they stored those weapons in arks, and they hid the arks all over the world.
Everyone on Grand Pulse knew the legend.
So, this is basically a Pulse armory.
Mm-hmm. Most of us never believed in them. A few people tried searching, but they never found a thing. Who'd have thought to look on Cocoon?
Right under our noses. Some secret they kept. Those Sanctum guys, what are they up to?
The story's not done. There's more.
They used to say the Arks had a more practical purpose.
Huh. Really?
Yeah. To force LaCie to master their shiny new powers.
Huh.
Okay, so, I get it. Dysley's goal is to forge us into stronger weapons. Right.
Not Seath, but monsters all the same.
Think of it as training for the fight ahead.
Hope's right.
Wait. What was that? These guys again.
Fun times.
Over there. We gotta keep moving.
Nothing I can't handle.
Huh.
New strategy.
You can do it.
Thanks. Keep a cool head.
Us up for the end of the world, huh?
We try to go back to Grand Pulse, and we end up here.
That's how it's done. Just another battle.
let's get this over with. Nothing personal. New strategy!